Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim è un vero e proprio atto, è un'azione di Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Non sono soltanto delle lettere scritte con l'inchiostro, ma rappresentano qualcosa di più grande.
Hochatal Islam, Abbas Di Palma, is an Italian mullah who is the director of the Imam Mahdi Islamic Center in Rome, which was established by the Iranian regime. He is one of the 50,000 non-Iranian mullahs who have studied at the Al Mustafa International University during the past 7 years. Al Mustafa was founded by the Iranian regime in 2007, and the Iranian Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei holds the highest authority in the university. Al Mustafa's main campus is the Iranian city of Qom, but it has branches in more than 60 countries around the world and trains foreign mullahs who then spread the Iranian regime's ideology throughout the world. Graduates of Al Mustafa are selected by the Iranian regime to direct religious and cultural centers in many countries. These centers recruit among local populations, thus are part of the Iranian regime's web of influence in the Islamic world. This is a 2010 meeting of Al Mustafa students with Ali Khamenei in Qom.
خیلی خوشوقتم از اینکه امروز این توفیق را پیدا کردم که در جمع شما طلاب و فضلای عزیز غیر ایرانی این دقایق با ارزش را داشته باشم. شما از نزدیک به 100 کشور در اینجا جمع شده اید تا با معارف اسلام ناب نجات بخش آشنا بشید. شما امروز این فرصت بزرگ را در جمهوری اسلامی در جامعه مبارک المصطفى این فرصت رو دارید که با این معارف آشنا بشید.
Since the Islamic Revolution, the Iranian government has invested largely in setting up seminaries for foreign students to come and learn the Shia teachings of Islam.
As you see, different nationalities we have here from Africa, from all the continents, like Africa, Europe, America, Australia, Asia, and even from United States, Canada, around the world.
On the 25th of October, Ayatollah Khamenei met with some of the students and Islamic scholars studying in these schools. One of Qom's most prestigious theology schools is the Al Mustafa International University. We spoke to some of the students studying here after their meeting with the leader.
As far as I know, this was the first time he met with foreign students. It's been the height of my stay in Iran so far, so that's the bit, I mean, it's the best thing that's happened to me in Iran. So I think it's really good, and it encourages foreign students to come here, work harder, study harder, because the rehbar himself is interested in our development. So that's very important for us.
It was very welcoming to the students to know that we are very welcomed in Iran, that this Iran is our home, and that we should not feel strangers in Iran. Secondly, we should appreciate and take heed of the knowledge that is apparent in Iran. We should use that when we go back to our own countries to try and make people aware of real Islam.
The other things, you know, he talked about was, you know, ilm without basira, which was one thing that really, really mattered.
The other thing he talked about, which was very important, was the hawza and studying deep knowledges. And that's like right now in the international hawza, we have the subjects are shallow, the books are small. And you see in the Iranian houses, the books are much bigger and deeper and studies are much longer.
He led us that we are, even we are foreigners from other countries, we came to study here, we should feel home. We should feel like we are not strange or other people, like we are much more better than the people of Iran. We even call us that we are his own generations after him, let me say.
The colossal financial cost to support the vast network of Al Mustafa shows the very high priority that the Iranian regime places upon exporting its ideology around the world, and demonstrates the great effort that Iran is making to gain leadership of the Islamic world. Since the Islamic Republic was established in Iran in 1979, Exporting the Islamic Revolution has been a main pillar of this regime.
نهضت برای اسلام نمیتوند محصور باشد در یک کشور و نمیتوند محصور باشد در حتی کشورهای اسلامی
کشوری که میخواهد عدل الهی را در جهان بپا کند و در همه جا حکومت اسلامی باشد
اولین درسی که انقلاب اسلامی و نظام مبارک جمهوری اسلامی به ما داد این بود که ما نگاهمون را از حصار و چهار دیواری ملت ایران منعطف کنیم به عرصه وسیع امت اسلامی.
From the earliest years of the revolution, the regime began sending Iranian mullahs to other Islamic countries to propagate its fundamentalist revolutionary ideology. Later, foreign candidates were brought to Iran to be educated, then sent back to their native countries. With the number of these foreign candidates increasing, the regime established several organizations to train them in Iran. Later, affiliated schools were established in foreign countries. In 2007, the Iranian regime merged all these teaching organizations together and founded the Al-Mustafa University in Qom. The official website of Al-Mustafa states that during the past 7 years, the university has had more than 50,000 male and female students in attendance, coming from 122 countries, and that it now has more than 3,500 full or part-time teachers inside and outside Iran. The main campus of Al-Mustafa is located in Qom. Other campuses are in Tehran, Mashhad, and Gorgan. Al-Mustafa also has more than 170 associated educational institutions, both inside Iran and in more than 60 other countries. The most important branch of Al-Mustafa abroad is the Islamic College of London.
Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Islamic College in London.
According to Al-Mustafa's website, during the past 7 years, the university has organized more than 5,000 cultural and religious events. It runs more than 4,000 websites and web blogs and produces 300 cultural publications in 40 different languages. In order to recruit, Al-Mustafa promises jobs and opportunities to the poor in several African and Asian countries. It then sends these recruits to its centers in Iran or abroad to be trained, then used in missions. Students who come to Iran are provided with generous financial support, accommodation, health and medical services for themselves and even for their families.
طلاب غیر ایرانی، فضلای غیر ایرانی بدانند که آنها در ایران اسلامی غریبه نیستند. شما حتی مهمان هم نیستید. شما صاحب خانه اید. شما فرزندان عزیز من هستید
After graduation, foreign students return to their own countries to work in the Islamic centers established by the regime, where they participate in various pro-regime activities. A good example is Abbas de Palma, mentioned at the beginning of this report. De Palma graduated from Al-Mustafa, then became director of the Imam Mahdi Islamic Center in Rome. In Rome, De Palma organizes religious ceremonies, recruits among the local population, notably Muslim immigrants, and also organizes political events to support the Iranian regime. Here, We see De Palma with some of these so-called leftist activists who have gathered at the Iman Mehdi Center to support Syrian President Bashar al-Assad and to support the Iranian regime's military involvement in Syria. Al-Mustafa's global network is an essential tool for the Iranian regime to extend its influence throughout the Islamic world. It has spread throughout Western countries too. This vast network could provide the Iranian regime with a tool to carry out terrorist activities.